Thank you, sir. Like, just because of the, I'm in charge for poster podium presentation. I'm short of lot of faculty and even judges. That's why I have to rush to my sessions. Thank you. I'll be talking about monofocal, multifocal, trifocal, or extended depth of focus, which is the best for my patient. So as you all know, that crystalline lens has got a good accommodation, clear vision at all distance, and got a great contrast sensitivity, no rotational asymmetry, and minimal aberration. My question, can an intraocular lens can do the same job as the natural lens? Of course, most of us, I think, first choice will be monofocal intraocular lens, because we tell the patient he'll have a very least halocent glare, and if you counsel them properly, for they have to wear glasses for near vision, I think they are going to be the happy. And nowadays, as Balla was telling, that the even lenses are coming with the aspheric platform also. So coming to the multifocal, it has got, nowadays I think diffractive multifocal has been very much popular in the market. It has got a smooth transition between the focal point. So these are the few advantage to overcome that. Now trifocal also in the market from the last 2 years, because of the most of the patients are like wanted intermediate vision, especially computer professionals, drivers, even painters, they wanted intermediate vision, which has been taken care by this trifocal IOL. So these are the advantage of multifocal intraocular, and definitely patient will have a good distance vision, intermediate and near vision also. Of course, they are free from the glasses, but some of the patient definitely has to compromise their lifestyle also. Glare, halo, especially in night hours. And some patients still, in spite of putting multifocal or trifocal, they have to wear glasses for near vision. Especially people like us, surgeons, I think, I don't recommend these particular lenses. So I think those who want to really want to undergo multifocal or trifocal, the patient has to be really alert to be spectacle independent. So we need to ask them the occupational history. Of course, for most of the patient, even if they are having a short-term halos or glare in the night driving, they cannot tolerate. So such patients sometimes, often we go back and we give them the option of monofocal intraocular lens. So the patients, especially those who want to be really, they don't want to wear the glasses for distance and near, but a lot of them, even they do a lot of night activity. So this extended depth of focus intraocular lens, which is a excellent compromise of the benefits of both monofocal and multifocal intraocular lens, more spectacle independence compared to monofocal intraocular lens with little bit of few side effects compared to the multifocal intraocular lens. Especially it is very attractive to those who have got a active lifestyle, even night activity. So this is the perfect balance between the spectacle independence and the less visual side effect. So I have been putting a lot of trifocals in the last 2 to 3 years, but always I counsel them, and we need to take their history, whether patient really doesn't want to wear the glasses at all. If really doesn't want to wear the glasses at all, they don't mind halos and glare. If they don't have the night activity, still I prefer to put them the trifocal intraocular lens. So this is just the technology. In the trifocal lens, it has got a sharp edge, but in extended depth of focus, it has got a smooth edge. That is the reason for they'll have a lesser halo and glare and halos. Just want to tell you how this lenses has been manufactured. It has got a, like trifocal, it has got 2 power addition, not for near, one for intermediate, that is at 70 centimeter, they have given plus 1.9 diopter, and for intermediate, that is around 140 centimeter, plus 0.95 diopter. So, this is a small study I picked from Germany. They did a comparison between monofocal, trifocal, and along with the one more trifocal competitive brand, along with the extended depth of focus, that is the LARA 829MP. Definitely, the night glare and halos will be there, but much lesser compared to the trifocal, little bit more than the monofocal intraocular lens. So patient satisfaction, at least 71% of the patient, once again, doesn't want to wear the glasses for near. Still 29% of the patient wanted glasses for finer prints. So this is a small comparison between the one more brand in the market. Just about the defocus curve, it has got a smooth defocus curve compared to the other brand in the market. And one more thing, whatever the biometry you do, same biometry IOL Master or LensStar gives, same lens power if you implant, I think that is going to give you the perfect results. So The other advantage what you have seen, I think post-LASIK patient, we never used to recommend them for putting multifocal or trifocal lens. But since because of its neutral asphericity, these lenses still you can put post-LASIK patients. And of course, even it is less sensitive for decentration and tilt. And it has got a hydrophilic lens with a hydrophobic surface on the posterior surface. You can even put through 1.8 or 2 mm incision, and it has got a anti-PCO coating in the posterior surface of the lens. So this is about the summary, and this is the first lens. I did it in India way back 1 year before. Same like any of the Zeiss lenses, 4 haptic lenses. When you're doing a capsular axis, key point, always better to do around 4 to 5 mm capsular axis. Then I think everybody is nowadays do a fantastic phaco. So as simple as that. So what I felt compared to the other lenses, these 4 haptic lenses, if your rexis is little bit off center also, most of my lenses are staying exactly in the center. So there is the off centering of the lenses is, which is much lesser in our cases. So this is about the video, and just 30 seconds, I'll just show you this video and I'll conclude my talk. So just go inside and inject, okay. So this is our experience, 90 eyes of 45 patients in 1 year, 85.7% had 6-9 or better vision for monocular and 100% binocularity, and all 100% of the patient read N8, and none of the patient had a night vision problem. Of course, it's an excellent compromise of the benefits of both monofocal and multifocal intraocular lens, more spectacle independence compared to monofocal lens, fewer side effects of multifocal intraocular lens. Once again, I thank the judges to give me opportunity in between. Thank you, one and all.